do I bring training or do I bring coaching? If no, we've heard about consciousness when we've done a book study ourselves, and we feel like we're ready to have a little bit more coaching. We feel like we're ready to really roll our sleeves up and get serious about this. Then you want to bring a coach in so that modeling can happen and so that they can experience what the words and the language and the structure sound like from a consciousness one coach.
We actually had been through training, so as another step is a coach kind of would come in and actually work with a teacher. We set up to where they would come in, and they're very hands-on. So how it benefited the school is the teachers can actually see a coach model a circle time, model the safe place, model one of the structures with the kids from their class. You actually got to see it happen in your room with your children.
A ver, aguántalo y dile triste, dile, respira.
Respira triste.
So it wasn't like you go off somewhere and, oh yeah, that's perfect. If I had those children, my classroom would look like that too.
When our coach came in and worked with us, she did so many different things with us. There was a time that she came in and she just sat with each team. And basically, she was like, okay, so talk to me. What concerns do you have in your classroom? And you know, that was the first time we learned about the executive skills, which was a huge game changer for us. One time, she just walked around the building with us and helped point out some things that we didn't recognize that we were doing.
I think one of the biggest benefits was to actually have them with a group of kids and actually model handling conflict. So in a classroom, things will happen. Somebody will take somebody's crayon, or, you know, there's just the little things, but to see how that coach handles that situation, and you as an observer can see and then be able to debrief about it.
She's walked into classrooms and looked at the way the structures are set up in the class and gave us tons of ideas of how to start school-wide and then break it down to where it ends up in the classroom. So that, huge piece for our campus.
Always you're gonna be jogging back and forth between training and coaching, because you can only receive so much content before you need to practice. And so you're never gonna stop training and probably never gonna stop coaching. You're just gonna constantly be bouncing back and balancing between the two.